Good evening. Welcome to Left, Right and Center. I'm Vishnu Shom on the program tonight. On Republic Day, a crazy situation in the national capital. Thousands of farm law protesters break police barricades and storm into the national capital. Violent clashes with the police in which more than 80 police personnel, we're now told, have been injured. The protesters stormed into Red Fort as well. There were very violent clashes there. Where was the leadership of the farm law protesters? Has the violence completely destroyed the campaign of the farmers who want the three controversial farm laws to be removed and for which they've been protesting for more than 2 months on the outskirts of Delhi? And later on the show, let us not forget it is Republic Day. We bring you an interview with the Bangladesh contingent which marched today on Republic Day at the parade as India and Bangladesh celebrate 50 years of our diplomatic relationship. But first, a quick couple of images of what happened today. The very latest information on the clashes. Some farmers are now beginning to turn back to the border where they've been protesting for 2 months. One farmer at least has died in what the police say was a tractor accident. The Home Minister Amit Shah has been holding meetings with the Delhi police. There were violent protests in several parts of Delhi, including at the Red Fort, at ITO and the interstate bus terminal, also in parts of outer Delhi. The clashes began after protesters pushed past barricades. Several union leaders have disassociated themselves from the violence. The BJP, the Congress, the Aam Aadmi Party, the Shiromani Akali Dal have criticized the violence and the farmer protests. Has the farmers' fight against the farm laws been weakened? Well, let's go straight across at this stage to our panel. We are joined by Yogendra Yadav, the National President of Swaraj India. Hanan Mola joins us as well. Naib Singh Saini, the Lok Sabha MP from Kurukshetra. Vikram Singh, the former Director General of Police. And Prakash Chandra Sharma, the National Vice President of the BJP's Kisan Morcha with us. But first, let me go across to Yogendra Yadav. Mr. Yadav, who's responsible for the violence today?
First of all, let me begin by saying that what happened was very regrettable and condemning. This is not what we had designed. This is not what we had hoped for. And as persons involved in giving a call for this, we take moral responsibility.
So you were responsible partly?
At the same time, let us understand what happened.
You were partly responsible, along with other farmer leaders, for the violence today?
What I'm saying, Vishnu, if you just allow me to complete what I'm saying, is that this was a deliberate act of sabotage. Two groups that have been identified in this so far have nothing to do with Sanyukt Kisan Morcha. One is Mr. Deep Sidhu, who Sanyukt Kisan Morcha and Farmers Movement had rejected for the last 3 months, actually almost 4 months. He's a persona non grata for the Farmers Movement. And the second is Kisan Mazdoor Sangharsh Samiti, which is not part of even 400 organizations which have backed this Farmers Movement. At the same time, because we gave a call and we allowed these people to sabotage, this was an act of sabotage, we cannot escape the responsibility. Others should also probably be held accountable, because what happened in the Red Fort was nothing short of the Capitol Hill scandal. How can anyone walk into the Red Fort and hoist the kind of flag they want to? This is something that someone needs to answer. So lots of answers to be given. And lots of responsibilities to be fixed, but we do not shirk our responsibility.
Okay. Naib Singh Saini, Saini Saab, aapne suna hoga, Yogendra Ji jo keh rahe the. Okay, let me just, in fact, we don't have him as yet. We've got Prakash Chandra Sharma. Sharma Ji, Yogendra Ji jo keh rahe the, is pe aapka reaction kya hai? Unko kehna tha ki aaj sabotage hua hai, aur kuch groups the, jinhone isko encourage kiya hai.
Vishnu, it's a very funny situation what Mr. Yogendra Yadav is saying now. He should be like, he should take all the responsibility, not partially, but fully. He was the man who was claiming like he has all the data with him. How many tractors are coming? What is the numbers of the tractor? What is the identity of the person? And at the time when all this anarchy was getting in the roads of Delhi, where the population is more than 2 crores, these people was in the shadow. They was in the protected area. What they were doing? So this was the total anarchy made by this group of people, so-called farmers. They should be shameless, national. All the nation is those, there is a regret on that.
Like, no, but there was a specific allegation, sir. It is regrettable. It goes without saying what happened today is a disgrace. But the allegation of sabotage, reply to that, the allegation of sabotage.
It is not about the sabotage, Vishnu. It is about the emotion. It is about the symbol. It is about legal, what they did. But we should salute the government and this police, what they did today. And they have protected all the Delhi. They want to burn the Delhi. Now they are saying this group was there at that particular time. Why they don't? They have not informed the police. Why they
okay,
have
that's
not
a specific question.
To the concern.
Yogendra ji, please answer that question. There why did you not tell the Delhi police about the presence of this actor who you believe was part of a group that instigated the protests?
Number one, we had indeed informed Delhi police not once but several times throughout yesterday about this organization called Mazdoor Kisan Sangharsh Samiti, which gave a call, which resisted, they broke the barricades. We repeatedly informed Delhi police that this group is out of control, this group does not belong to us, and there is no one who can discipline this group. They actually are standing, they're not even in our arena, they're outside the barricade, number one. Number two, as far as Mr. Deep Sidhu is concerned, I must inform the BJP about something very, very interesting. Mr. Deep Sidhu was the right-hand man and almost the election agent of Mr. Sunny Deol, who was BJP candidate in the last election. Did you hear me clearly? He was election agent for BJP in the last election. Should I inform BJP about it?
No, sir. There are photographs also, Mr. Yadav. But do you mean to say that Deep Sidhu, one individual, and apparently he was there with one other person, instigated upwards of what, 5,000-10,000 at least, farmers, plus more than that, to come into Delhi today?
No, I have about coming to Delhi. The principal
entering
organization
Delhi
is
today. Entering Delhi today.
The organization that instigated and actually broke the barrier is Kisan Mazdoor Sangharsh Samiti, about which we had informed Delhi police. We had, throughout yesterday, we had long conversations with Delhi police about this organization. No one was in any doubt about what this organization is. And about the incident inside Red Fort, someone must answer this question. This is not short, smaller than the Capitol Hill scandal that we witnessed in the US 2 weeks ago.
It's not.
How can anyone march into Red Fort and hoist any flag that they want? And should the farmers answer this question or should someone else answer this question?
But sir, it was the farmers who did this.
Army contingent.
Farmers were part of the protest in Red Fort as well.
Or any of the farm leaders or farm organizations involved in this protest, part of the Red Fort contingent and giving a call for Red Fort. Let's find out facts and let's answer that.
Okay. Mr. Sharma, respond to that. Who, the farmer leaders say they have nothing to do with what happened at Red Fort and flags being raised and things like that.
Vishnu, see, things are very clear. When the discussions were going on with the Delhi police, all the time the government was not in a position and they were avoiding, trying to avoid them. He is the gentleman who is taking all the responsibility. And when this, all the things was, the mess was happened, he was out of the turn. His picture was not there. They were not leading the part. Secondly, if you will see one interesting thing, all the borders, either we will talk about the Ghazipur or Sindhu border or some other border, they are the men, they are just putting all their dera and dandas over there. And they are holding the area. So in that particular region, when they have the holding area with them, they have the control with them, why the Mr. Sadhu came immediately and did this at that particular time where they was? Why they have not informed the police and what their own intelligence was doing it? It is something when the nation same issue was there. Internationally, these people had put our head down. When this vaccine diplomacy is going on, every WHO and all other nations are appreciating
that's
us.
A separate thing.
These kind of people, what they did today on the national day, on a particular, the symbolic radio with the tricolor, what they did, they should feel same on this.
Okay.
Rather in that particular position.
No, it is shameful. It goes without saying. We are trying to understand why it took place. Hanan Molla, do you have, as General Secretary of the All India Kisan Sabha and Member Coordination Committee of the Samyukt Kisan Morcha, do you have any answers for who is responsible, Mr. Molla?
We were waiting for this vilification campaign. 7 months we are fighting. 7 months. 70 crore farmers, their existence is in danger. And where these people, knowledgeable people are there, when 4 lakh people committed suicide, these people live on farmers' podas, and now they are blaming the farmers. They are same on them. These people, they are calling farmers terrorists.
Most respectfully, we know. You can say that the farmers were instigated, but the farmers were a part of the violence today as well, sir. You can say farmers were instigated.
A section.
But that doesn't condone their behavior.
All farmers, you know, But I am saying those two groups are not part of the movement. They are organized and they are criminal people. There are criminals also. Government knows it. We told that these criminals should not be allowed in that to do that. How they have reached there? What are they doing? We did, I don't know, crores of people participated today. Crores. In 700 districts, 27 state capital and Delhi. Crores of farmers participated in this protest. But where some criminal activities were organized because it was instigated to blame this movement. 7 months, we are fighting, not a single incident happened. But we are afraid that their conspiracy is going on. Inside country, outside country, their conspiracy was going on to create problem. We are very much conscious about that. We tried our best. Thousands of volunteers we put, but in spite of that, those who conspire, they slip inside, and that created, then today the farmers are being blamed. Farmers' problem are not, nobody is there. Farmers are suffering, their existence in trouble.
I think we need to also today, sir, reflect on the condition of the police.
Largest movement in the Mr. Mola,
one moment.
After independence.
I want to go across to Vikram Singh, the former Director General of Police of UP as well.
Largest movement in the country after independence. Most peaceful.
No, Mr. Mola, after independence. I understand what you are trying to say and all about your protest.
To blame these
but
farmers.
I think there needs to be a word of sympathy for the families and for the policemen who have been injured. Mr. Prakash Singh, Mr. Vikram Singh, there have been 83 at last count policemen, police personnel who've been injured. A few of them, I'm told, are critical as well. This is a crazy situation on Republic Day in Delhi. 83 of them have been injured. Your thoughts
Vishnu, on this? Vishnu, anybody's heart would bleed to see this unmitigated disaster and that too on the Republic Day. Damaging as it is to our prestige in the international world, its material consequences and its cost in terms of men and material is going to be even worse and the far-reaching consequences. I would like to compliment the Delhi police on one side for once that they displayed exemplary restraint so that there is not a situation where they would say that there is a reenactment of Jallianwala Bagh too. But I think that cause of restraint is now over. If there is a grave provocation of this nature, the law empowers and authorizes them to use proportionate force to contain the situation and maintain law and order as per the requirement of law. Now it should not be wanting. Obviously, the criminal elements had infiltrated the farmers' agitation and took the fullest advantage. That is why the insistence on having the march on the 26th, not on the 25th, not on the 27th, and the police in fact were battered. They were victimized and there was violent clashes, but the police did not resort to the use of force. This is what I feel is an exemplary show of tact and restraint. But I would say that now the time has come to use whatever is permissible under the rule of law and ensure that there is no repetition of such incidents. Announce rewards on all those who are identified through facial recognition softwares and the technology available. Identify them, reward them, and ensure that they are arrested early, register cases and see that all the mischief makers, whoever they are, they should be taken to task and exemplary punishment be given to them. That would be a befitting tribute to the fact that all the injuries to the police department, they would be suitably accounted for. Proper medical attention to them, proper attention as far as their medical requirements are concerned. And I think the police leadership have a problem at hand attending to their injured. 83 is almost a company strength. And also to see what's going to happen tonight and what's going to happen tomorrow. And also in the next 2 or 3 days. That is going to be very, very critical for Delhi and the nation.
Mr. Mola, what happens about your farmer protests now? The bill protests. What happens about it now?
By that protest, peaceful protest will continue. We are not part of this criminal activity. And our demands are there. Our existence is in trouble. Crores of people are suffering. And 7 months, a government failed to solve the problem. It is not responsibility. If the Prime Minister took over and solved the problem, this type of situation would not have been created. And when there's a mass movement, when your people's participation is massive, then some such thing happens. The government, a democratic government, they are not listening to the people. 150 people died sitting in zero degree temperature. Where was the humanity of these great people? No humanity has been shown to the farmers. So when they are suffering, nobody is there to relieve. When 4 lakh farmers committed suicide, these gentlemen are not seen.
All right.
Now they are shouting here in the television,
yeah,
and they are abusing the farmers. They are annadata. They produce food for you and you are abusing them. Shame on you.
All right, Mr. Sharma, last comment to you. What happens, what can the centre do in a situation like this besides the legal process which will continue? Because the farmers' protests don't appear to have ended.
See, Vishnu, one thing is very clear. What happened today and what Mr. Haneemullah is saying, we are not in the age of 1950s or 1960s. It is 2021. See, government is giving due diligence and due deliberation for the issue. They have to talk about the issue. Just putting on the number and the so-called the farmers, if they do it, that is not acceptable. See, with the technique and many revolutions we have seen, many achievements we have achieved in this country. By doing this particular way, this is not acceptable to any of the citizen of the India. What they did today, they have not hit it today only to the police. They have also did the same aspect with the this media man. They have just dragged out their cameras and they did all the things. And everything is on record. So if they are saying we are doing the peaceful protest and we will not talk and government has to do this, this is a democratic nation where democracy exists, where a court process exists. And okay, everybody has a very specific respect for that process.
All right. One second, Mr. Vikram Singh. You had a point to make, sir. Quickly, sir.
I just had a point to make that everybody has, with due respect, even the Supreme Court has said, Vishnu, that the right to peaceful protest, this is by no stretch of imagination a peaceful protest, a violent protest, an insult to the tricolor and institution, and an insult to the Republic Day. And this has to be accounted for within the ambit of law. And nobody is above law. Neither Kisan, nor you, nor I. Everybody is accountable and is expected to respect the constitution and the tricolor. If he doesn't, well, the law will take its own course.
You know, there's some footage which we aren't playing out at this stage. And the allegation, in fact, it shows it, is of a woman police officer or a police woman being attacked as well. And there's a lot of other footage coming in of the violence against the police, which is really, really unfortunate. And it needs to be mentioned that the police attacking the farmers, whatever was the provocation, has taken place as well. I just want to go full frame to these particular images to give our viewers an idea of what happened today. It's important to understand that the violence was on both sides. What we are showing here, this has been sent across by ANI, is of the farmers pushing these farmers or these policemen. These policemen, in fact, having to jump off that particular wall after being attacked to save their lives. Unclear about what this location is, possibly Red Fort, not entirely sure what this location is. But this is a graphic example of what the police have had to go through today. Again, I want to mention that this is one side of the developments today. There were images of the police brutally assaulting the protesters in other areas as well. All of this on our Republic Day in our national capital. These images, in fact, from the Red Fort. Well, I'd like to thank our panelists very much for joining us at this stage. But as we play out these shots, I'd also like to bring in a couple of reports which we had, my colleague Srinivasan Jain, who was in this broad area when some of this violence had taken place. All right. Is actually the other side of what I was mentioning, the police attacking the farmer. So violence on both sides today, a frightening situation in India.
Put up here, they are beating them, they try to bring them. are milling around here. Many of them are carrying lathis and other forms of with them. The police and the security forces are nowhere to be seen. My colleague Parim personally saw. The protesters, so both things going on at the same time. The security forces being roughed up and also being taken out by some members of NDTV. And this is what you can see here at the Red Fort at the moment.
26th of January 2021, an iconic day here. Multiple tractors parked at the Red Fort, and there you see right at the peak. Some protesters have reached at that point as well. A few hours back, at much lower place, there were a couple of protesters who managed to wave that saffron flag. And now, right at the peak of the Red Fort, again, there are a number of protesters which have managed to go right up to that point. Again, they're trying to fix one saffron flag here. And if you see the situation on ground here, then there are multiple tractors lined up. They are raising slogans, and many protesters are here on their horses as well. So a different kind of situation being witnessed here at the Red Fort on 26th of January, Republic Day. Now, Kisan Gantantra Parade was planned by farmers, by farm unions, but that didn't go as per the plan. Finally, protesters starting from different borders have finally come together here at the Red Fort, where now there are cars, trolleys, tractors, horses, and a huge number of protesters waving the national flag, but their own flag as well. So there you see another attempt to wave more flags right at the peak on 26th of January 2021. With camera person Manoj Thakur, Arun Singh for NDTV.
Delhi police personnel along with the CAPF is using the tear gas to disperse the crowd here. In fact, we could see a camera person could show you the tractors have been stranded here. Now the police personnel are using tear gas and also lathi charge to disperse the crowd here. In fact, earlier we saw some of the farmers, they insisted that they wanted to march ahead, whereas the police did not allow them. Though some farmers tried to breach the barricade here and then march again, they were pushed back by Delhi police personnel along with CAPF with tear gas shell and also lathi charge.
Unbelievable scenes in the national capital, huge violence. What's going to take place next? Is this effectively the end of these farmer protests in the way that we've seen peaceful protests over the last several months? What about the angle of sabotage, which farmer leaders are now alleging? What about all of the dozens, the 80 plus policemen and police women, we are now told, who've been injured? Will there be action against those who are responsible for this? So many unanswered questions. It's something we'll track very closely. But let's not forget, today is Republic Day. It is a day when we always try and remember what our country, what our India means to us. We had very special guests today on Republic Day, a contingent marching from Bangladesh. This is the 50th anniversary of diplomatic relations. This year is the 50th anniversary of diplomatic relations between Dhaka and New Delhi, and therefore the presence of this Bangladeshi contingent was important.
Well, it's Republic Day today, a fantastic honor for us in our country to welcome and to have a spectacular Bangladeshi contingent over here present in the Republic Day parade. They were marching today. They've got members of all of their arms over here, and it marks 50 years of a fantastic diplomatic relationship between New Delhi and Dhaka. Well, joining us now, the team leader and some of the officers of the Bangladeshi contingent over here. Colonel Chaudhary, thanks very much. And it's wonderful. We saw the parade on television. What was the experience like marching today?
It was great. It was exciting. We enjoyed marching here. And honestly speaking, there was a lot of hardship put into this practice. And today it became a successful one. That's why we are also very much happy.
Yeah. Could you tell us a little bit about the squad which was brought over here? When did you first know that you were going to come over here? And it's three services, right?
We have members from three services. That's correct. And we came to know about this parade in last December, at the end of the December. And since then we started preparing for this one. We took a couple of days to gather people from specified units, because you know that these people are from units which participated in during the liberation war. So they had to be accumulated, came together, they practiced, and the Navy, Army, Air Force, they have a different pattern, but they were marching in the same contingent. So some bit of practice for that purpose also. Finally, we came here. There is a COVID situation, so some protocols had to be maintained. Again, we had to practice in this environment, prepare ourselves, and finally, today we had to participate.